The big story that is breaking at this hour is an announcement by the government, a package for sugarcane farmers that amounts to nearly 8,000 crores. This is significant politically because it has been widely believed that one of the big reasons for the BJP not doing well in Uttar Pradesh, in the Kairana bipole in particular, was because sugarcane farmers in this region were particularly unhappy. Is this a result of that? Sunetra Chaudhary is joining us for more on that big story. Sunetra, what more do we know about this package? And of course, the timing isn't lost on anyone.
That's right. Just a few days after the UP defeat, bipole defeat of Kairana, which everyone, if you ask them, they said basically the government had continued with the policies of the previous government when it came to sugarcane farmers and hadn't done anything special. And of course, today is also the day that Yogi Adityanath met with the BJP President Amit Shah. And they felt this had to be fixed immediately, Uttar Pradesh, because they're looking at the prospect of the entire united opposition against the BJP. And so, without wasting any time, and they have said, announced this 8,000 crore rupees package. Now, one of the most important parts of this is to give a MSME, the minimum support price. And for this, that is 29 rupees per kg. Some of the other parts of this is they are saying they're going to create a buffer stock of 30 LMP, and this, they said, will be money transferred directly to the accounts of the sugarcane farmers, and it will facilitate clearing of cane dues for them. Remember, one of the things has been the frustration of the sugarcane farmers in the particular area. They're also saying the package will have a major scheme worth more than 4,400 crores for increasing the ethanol capacity in the country, which will help in diversion of sugarcane for production of ethanol in a surplus season to facilitate timely payment of sugarcane to the farmers. So,
right. So
the details are being worked out. What is clear is that they don't want angry farmers on their hands yet again.
Well, for the moment, the farmers are angry. It'll be interesting to see how this announcement plays out. Sunetra, thanks for that. And in fact, as we were mentioning, the farmers groups, there are about 130 of them. They are under an umbrella organization. They have called for a 10-day strike that began on the 1st of June. And that impact is now slowly being seen in different parts of the country. For instance, in the vegetable markets of Rajasthan, prices of vegetables have actually gone up by 50% in the last 4 days since the strike actually began. Now, these farmers who are protesting want the government to implement the recommendations of the Swaminathan Commission, which basically long ago in 2006 had talked about how to make agriculture profitable. These farmers also want complete loan waivers and pensions for old farmers.
Farmers refusing to supply milk and vegetables to cities, setting up shop on the roads, in some cases forcefully spilling milk that had been collected by dairy cooperatives for supply to cities. Just 30 kilometers from Jaipur, farmers are giving away their produce rather than sell in protest against what they call the increasing unprofitability of agriculture.
जो लागत का मूल्य है वो हमारी चौथाई परसेंट भी नहीं मिल रहा है रुपए में चार आने भी नहीं मिल रहा है तो मजबूर हो गए हमने सारे हिंदुस्तान के काश्तकारों ने किसानों ने एकता बनाई है ताकि जो भी चीज अपनी पैदा होगी दूध वगैरह फ्रूट वगैरह वो बाजार में सप्लाई नहीं करेंगे.
Since the 1st of June, the Rashtriya Kisan Sangh, a farmers' union, has decided to block the sale of fruits and vegetables in cities. Its impact visible in parts of Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh and Maharashtra. The supply of milk has also gone down by about 2 lakh litres, as farmers have locked milk collection centres in some places. In other cases, they have attacked milk tankers by opening valves and spilling milk on the roads. A Jaipur dairy has filed 12 police reports in just 4 days against members of farmers' unions.
Average हमारा 11 लाख लीटर दूध है. कल हमारे पास 4 लाख लीटर दूध कम आया. जो कम दूध आया उसकी पूर्ति हमने अन्य जो हमारी मिल्क यूनियन से उनसे मंगाकर पूरी करके और आज हमने 8 लाख 40 हजार लीटर का जयपुर शहर में वितरण किया है.
Where milk prices remain unaffected, vegetable prices are soaring. Tomato prices are almost double now. Onions and potatoes up by 15%.
Jaipur mein ya to sabzi mil nahi rahi, mil rahi hai to bahut mehngi mil rahi hai. Mirchi 40 rupaye kilo aur jo aloo jaisi cheeze bahut sasti hoti hai wo 30 rupaye kilo aur bhindi ke bhav to bas aasman ko chhu rahe hain 40 rupaye kilo.
The most visible price rise has been in vegetables locally supplied like gourd, tomato and chilies. And if the kisan agitation continues like this, there could be another hike in prices in the coming days. In Jaipur, Harsha Kumari Singh, NDTV.
Well, as I tweeted earlier, this is a story that hasn't made it to the front page of India's newspapers as much as it should have. It's an important story and it is something that has huge political significance ahead of the general elections. Joining us tonight, Pawan Khera, spokesperson of the Congress Party. We have Mr. Deshratan Nigam, who's a senior lawyer and analyst and supporter, a sympathizer of the BJP. Prandeep Bhandari, the founder of the portal Jan Ki Baat, also a sympathizer of the BJP. Devinder Sharma, food and trade policy analyst, joining us tonight. And Avik Saha, founding member of Yogi Indri Yadav's Swaraj Abhiyan, also joining us this evening. Mr. Devinder Sharma, let me ask you first about this big announcement for sugarcane farmers that's just come in the last 10 minutes. What do you think? Will it give sugarcane farmers the relief that they're looking for? 8,000 crore package and an MSP announced?
Well, I think we have to look into the final details still. But one thing is very clear, the pending dues of sugarcane farmers is 20,000 crores. And 20,000 crores is not a small amount. Out of this 8,000 crores that the government has spelled out, much of it is for ethanol diversion, for storage or so on and so forth of sugar. But how do you address the issue of non-payment of dues of farmers? Now, this is something which the government has announced earlier that for 15 days they will be able to give farmers his whatever is due to him. But we have seen over the time period that the dues are pending. And now it totals about 20,000 crores. So I think it is just a peanut what has been addressed. More important is when Saurashtra happened, if you remember in Saurashtra when the results went against the BJP mandate they were expecting, they had tinkered with a couple of things before the elections, like raising the cotton prices or providing more MSP for pulses and so on. Now the question is, why do we have to go for these kind of peaceful arrangements? Why can't we actually address the issue in totality, in a holistic manner? That is where the government is failing. And I think we must understand that the agriculture crisis is very serious in this country. Look at all the reports in the last 4 years. The terms of trade have been negative against agriculture. This is what the official data is available. We have also seen the Niti Aayog telling us that the real income of farmers in 5 year period between 2011 and 2016 has only increased by less than 0.5% every year. 0.44% is the increase every year in real income in those 5 years. In the last 2-3 years, the rains have been benevolent. But look at the crisis that agriculture faces. Farmers have been selling tomato or throwing tomatoes on the streets. 50 paisa is what they are getting. 1 rupee.
No, you're making a very important point there. And as you say, Mr. Sharma, the crisis is very, very serious. It's very, very deep. Let me ask Mr. Nikam about that. Devinder Sharma is skeptical. When the dues are 20,000 crores for sugarcane farmers, 8,000 crores isn't going to cut it. And then one does have to wonder where the money is going to come from. But do you agree with him that these are piecemeal arrangements, that we need to have a more holistic approach?
No, not exactly. If you look at the sugarcane dues of UP, the problem was with the sugarcane companies. They were not, in fact, forwarding the names of these beneficiaries. That actually delayed the whole process. The government has the money. It has to go to the right kind of people. And 8,000 crore, I think, is a good beginning. And obviously, with the arrangements of diversion for ethanol and all, will be a cushion for these sugarcane farmers. And also, if you look at it, sugarcane is
just... But it seems the government has kind of got stung by what happened in Kerala and has reacted now with this package.
See, not exactly. These elections will come and go. You need to find a permanent solution. Unless and until you manage these sugar companies who try to, divert the money, nothing can be done. I'm very clear.
But it's not a coincidence that it happened today when Yogi Adityanath meets Amit Shah. You've had the
Everything is about politics. You've got to win elections, and you've got to take steps. And they have taken steps. I'm sure they have taken, and more steps would come into the picture. And if you look, this is just about sugarcane. What I see about these, let me tell you, in our society, food, fruits and vegetables are worshipped. When I see people throwing like that, I see a lot of politics in it. A lot of politics here, and I have seen videos where people who were going to deliver the milk, they were forced to throw. In fact, their milk was spread on the road. And one of the important...
Are you saying that all the farmers' protests are political?
See, let
they
me tell you.
They could be those who are see, just let me, actually
let
just
me,
frustrated.
Who are leading these? It is the middlemen and traders who are leading this. My information is that The middlemen and the traders are leading this agitation and financing it right now. I'm not saying there are not genuine issues with farmers, but this is about political optics, keeping 2019 in mind.
Okay. You said a couple of interesting things. Pawan Khera, let me get a quick response to that. First, on this package, and second, on what Mr. Nigam said, that he sees that these protests currently are largely politically driven.
As far as the package is concerned, Nidhi, it's too little too late. It's not that, I won't say that the BJP government is responsible for all that the farmers are facing. That will be very immature. It has been a long drawn crisis, but our objection is to the way this government responds to such crisis. Look at the agriculture minister, look at the insensitive remarks by him that they are doing it for the optics. I was shocked when my colleague Mr. Deshraj Nigam also said the same, almost the same, that it's for optics, it's politics. I am sorry, aap log to sampurna kranti ko support karte the, where even the police, you had asked the police to go on strike. Was that politics? Or you were genuinely concerned about some issues during, before emergency? So let's not accuse the farmers of playing politics. It's Bharti Kisan Sangh, Bharti Kisan Union, all the unions. In fact, even the Sangh supported Bharti Kisan Sangh is also supporting this strike.
No, it is not.
No, then I'm very surprised. Then I wanted you to say it on camera.
Because,
thank you.
I would have said the same thing.
This is where
I'll tell you the reasons also.
This is where politics comes in. The Bharti Kisan Sangh keeps itself away from such a fundamental issue, crisis the farmers of India are facing today. Why? Are they under pressure from the government? They definitely look to be under pressure. The last movement with Mandsaur, when the firing happened, Bharti Kisan Sangh was there, very active. In Rajasthan also, part of Bharti Kisan Sangh wanted to be desperately support.
So you're saying
the
problem is more in the way the government responds
to the crisis. If you look into every problem as politics, your response will be absolutely political and it will not help the farmers. As I just said, the comment by the agriculture minister, the comment by all the other senior leaders, they are trying to distract.
They are talking about
Osama bin Laden, they are talking about Hafiz Saeed, everything but farmers. They are trying to distract our attention from the fundamental issues that face the country
today. Kisan Sangh has always been in the forefront. When they realize that this is a political agitation, they have kept themselves away from it. Very clearly, this agitation is keeping 2019 in mind, and it is mostly led by traders and middlemen, who are most affected by this e-mandi.
But then you're making the mistake
when the rural crisis is real, nobody
is denying steps have been taken. Say for example, e-mandis, lot of e-mandis are being opened, more have to be operationalized, more storage facilities have to be created, you know, where like bumper crops takes place. And what do you do with it? You've got to link it with agri-based industries.
No, but the point is, and Pawan, I'll just come to you. The point is, Pradeep, has this become this government's Achilles heel in a sense? Is this what is going to test the BJP next year?
See, I believe that the rural voters will be very, very critical for the for the elections going forward in 2019. Now, last year, the agriculture growth rate was roughly around 2.45%. As per the latest GDP figures, right now, the agriculture growth rate is 4.4. So, the situation this year is not as bad as the situation was last year. Now, I have two fundamental problems. Yes, definitely, as Pawanji said, that it is an institutional problem and it has been a failure for sure. And the principal problem has been that the margin, 85% of your farmers are having less than 2 acres of land holding, and that is why these farmers need to be addressed with institutional support apart from loan waiver, which just solves the problem temporarily. Now, I don't have any problem with Congress being part of the protest. What I have issue is people from the Congress party throwing milk, right? Now, one farmer on an average spends 1,000 rupees for the milk of a buffalo. I absolutely did not say that. But even if some of the workers from the Congress party, they can support it. Absolutely any political party can support it. But if they pick up milk and throw it on the road,
please,
then it is absolutely
undermine a movement as strong as this by picking up one example and ignoring 10 examples of Congress helping in Punjab. Farmers are donating their stuff to Gurudwaras. That's also Congress. That is, you will ignore that.
I'm not ignoring it.
Please discuss the issue
Everybody does that.
I did not. I'm discussing it. And not the issue was one example.
The issue was, if I go on a political point, sir, then
no, that's very incorrect.
So I'm trying to, let me make my point. What I'm trying to say is that if a farmer spends 1,000 rupees on an average a day on a buffalo, I don't see genuine farmers largely throwing milk. Yes, some of them might be genuine, but yes,
is the farmer distress real or not?
Absolutely, the farmer situation is real. That is why the government is concerned and it has released the package. And I think it is not a sufficient step, but it is a forward step. Now, the prince, like you talked about, sugarcane, I want to tell you the situation today is much better because the farmer, the price of sugarcane that the farmer is getting right now in UP is much, much more than what it was getting 2 years
back. So, why were they so angry in Kerala?
Because the dues which were pending from the past 3 years, on which the Supreme Court also passed the judgment, despite that, the Akhilesh Yadav government did not act about it.
So that was Akhilesh's fault. No,
right now, the Yogi Adityanath government also needs to act on it. The government
then they would have punished Akhilesh.
No, they punished Akhilesh. Now, this government promised that in 14 days
so
they have to do it. Now,
the
they're doing it. See, last time
so
the farmer used to get it in 8 months.
Let me get Avik
now, they're getting
into
in 2 months. They
Avik
need to get it in 15 days.
How do you respond to the criticism or the allegations now that are being made that these farmer protests are politically driven, that they're largely been politicized? Is that what this is? Largely a politically driven movement? 130 farmer organizations, are they all left? Or Congress?
I don't know why anyone should have an objection to farmers' agitations being political. But the point is not that. Let me start with Pawan Khera. You see, the Congress sat on the Swaminathan report for 10 years. The agitations today are only with regard to price and indebtedness. I'm surprised that Mr. Nikam feels that traders are concerned with this issue. It's not the first agitation. Farmers all over the country, different organizations, different platforms are trying to get this problem resolved, and the government is not listening. So what you are seeing today, if you turn it into a trader-led movement and all these, you know, arguments, they sound good, but they're not true. The two core issues of price and indebtedness have nothing to do with the traders. And in fact, it's against the traders. The traders would like the farmers to remain in debt, to remain in crisis, so that they can exploit on prices. So this is contra logic. I don't know why it's being said on national television. It's unfortunate. And on sugarcane, I'm sorry. Please send a team to the Ganna belt. It's Western UP, very close to Delhi. The crisis has been looming, and the government, the BJP government in UP, has not been looking into it at all. And I hope this time they are serious about their package, however, you know, little or more it may be. But the previous interventions in terms of potato purchase, even in the loan indebtedness issues, have not been very happy. So yes, the BJP governments, both at the center and the state, now need to get serious about the farmers' issues.
But I think
and
to
that's
do that,
what
you
we
first
are hoping
have to,
for.
You have to first
this
acknowledge,
is not a
you
city
have to acknowledge
versus
that it's a
issue.
Genuine protest. And I think you make a good point. I mean, what is wrong if even if they are political protests, they're still farmers, okay?
So I think there's nothing wrong with that.
So therefore, Devinder Sharma, the point is, you can only deal with the problem if you recognize firstly what, you know, how serious the problem is. And do you get a sense that either that's not happening or they're trying to put on a brave face? Because how else does one explain the agriculture minister's statement, which Pawan referred to earlier, or Manohar Lal Khattar saying, well, these protests are pointless, there is no issue. When senior ministers and party leaders are dismissive of it, is it a brave face or is it, you know, just false bravado? What is it?
I think, Nidhi, you are absolutely right. You know, the problem is that everyone has been in a state of denial. you know, whether it is like this government or the previous government. I remember during the previous government's tenure also, when people like me would step out and stand with farmers, we were told we were BJP people. Now when farmers are standing up and we are standing again with them, we are being told we are Congress people. You know, so this kind of thing will go on. We can go on tossing the blame or tossing the onus for all these things. But the reality is agriculture is in a deep, deep crisis. And I am only surprised nobody has so far blamed Jawaharlal Nehru for it. I would be not, you know, this is what has been happening over the last few months. So thankfully, nobody has done it. But Jawaharlal Nehru had said one thing very clearly, even at that time. He had said, everything else can wait, but not agriculture. Unfortunately, in this country, it's only agriculture which we have kept in the waiting list or wait list, and everything else has been taken care of. The result today is that farmers are dying. You know, there's hardly a day when I don't see reports of farmers committing suicide in one part of the country or the other. Look at Punjab, which has 98% assured irrigation. It has a top productivity in the world when it comes to wheat, rice and maize. And yet farmers are dying every day. Punjab has become a hotspot of farmer suicides. Now, you can go on denying. You can go on denying that nothing is happening. Agriculture is one, let me tell you, is one sector which is going to be the sector that we must watch now politically, because after all, farmers are not going to take it lying down anymore. The results will be visible in the elections, in the next election that we are going to see, in the state elections, and the government must take blame for it. The tragedy is the agriculture minister, the chief ministers, they have all
everyone's
been in denial.
The buck. Everyone's passing the buck, and that's an important point. Pradeep, I'm sure you would agree with that. You know what's also astounding, because Devinder Sharma made a reference to farmer suicides. The government told Parliament in March this year that we don't have any data after 2016 16. On farmer suicides, because the Home Ministry hasn't published its report yet. That's quite something.
See, I think these statements, I think they're insensitive statements, and I do not agree with it. But I do not agree with your point saying that the government is not acknowledging the problem, because if the government would not have acknowledged the problem, it would not have released the sugarcane package. Now, the point,
I agree with you. So then why make statements like, well, it's political or it's,
Nidhi, the point is that the protest can be political. My issue is that why are you splitting milk, which is the same produce of the farmer? That is harming the farmer principally. So, and this is becoming antithetical to the whole movement. That is my point. I don't have problem with Congress people picking up agendas and protesting. That's their right to protest. I have no issues. The point is that you do an act which is antithetical to the protest, which is harming the farmer. That is my problem. That is then self-goal, is what I'm trying to say. I want to say a larger point. The larger point here is that you cannot address farming in the country till the time you do not get most of your farmers out of farming, because 86% of your farmers have left.
That's already happening, actually.
All these bromides the country has heard for the last 4 years. We were punished
for
20
years. They were for 20 years.
Please relax. We were punished for what we did not do. And I have no shame in admitting that. Now, in the last 4 years, MSP plus 50%, this government, the Prime Minister, the Finance Minister, the then Finance Minister, they've been lying left, right and center.
Prime Minister said, let me finish. But that is a factually
wrong
statement.
Now, that's the problem. It's not just one recommendation of the Swaminathan Commission. There are 12 recommendations, including commons for grazing. They are not even talking about it. Whenever land, it comes to the rights of farmers on land. They will not talk about
but
it.
But land leasing law has been tabled in the parliament.
Really,
sir, but
really
land leasing law has been tabled
no,
in the parliament.
No, it's not that land I'm talking about. You know what I'm talking about. I'm talking about
commons
for grazing.
You didn't implement.
I agree. I told you that we got punished for a lot of reasons.
That's a very, convenient
no,
argument.
No, it's not convenient.
You, yes,
you, don't, you are not convenient when you lose elections. You'll soon realize in 2019.
We will see about it.
Nothing convenient about losing an election. Aapko 2019 mein pata chal jayega. Election aarna kya hota hai.
We both are here and we'll be sitting in this studio.
Kisanon ki baat karna hai.
Welcome to
2019 आपको दिखता है आंदोलन में, और पैकेज में आपको 2019 नहीं दिखता. आपके न पन्ना प्रमुख चले, न धन्ना प्रमुख चले, चले तो सिर्फ गन्ना प्रमुख चले. आपकी आंखें खोल दी कैराना ने, मानिए इस सबके सामने.
सी, लेट मी रिस्पॉन्ड.
वाज कैराना अ वेक अप कॉल, यू थिंक, फॉर द गवर्नमेंट ऑन फार्मर इश्यूज?
सी, इट्स सर्टेनली द लॉस,
एनी इवन महाराष्ट्र,
एनी लॉस शुड बी अ वेक अप कॉल फॉर एनी पॉलिटिकल पार्टी. बीजेपी इज नॉट एन एक्सेप्शन टू इट. वन. सेकंडली, लेट मी आंसर टू वन ऑफ द पैनलिस्ट हु सेज that it is not being led by traders or middlemen. The e-mandis, the concept of e-mandis, which is eliminating the middlemen and traders, is agitating them a lot, because there is a direct connection is being made with the farmers who can sell their produce directly, eliminating all these middlemen. It is they who are getting most agitated out of
it. Avik Saab, how are the e-mandis doing according to you?
No, it is.
Okay, let me ask Mr. Saha about it.
No, let me just See, I know that it is not much, but it is progressing. Okay. And the Mr. effort Saha, is to quick. Make it more.
Yeah. Mr. Saha, 30 seconds scale. Quickly. How are these e-mandis doing? Where are they?
The e-mandis are not operational. I've traveled to 7 states. I have traveled to 12 mandis. They don't work. Like many other things of Mr. Modi's government, this is a figment of his imagination, and his followers are coming on television and spreading this fabricated story again and again and again. There is nothing called e-mandi in India as on today.
All right, well, exactly. I think we need to do a reality check on that, but I'd like to thank all of you for coming here. Thank you for coming tonight. I'd like to revisit this subject, though, of the farmers and what's happening with them. There is going to be a big protest in Mandsaur in Madhya Pradesh. If you remember, 6 farmers were killed in police firing there last year. There is going to be a big protest there day after tomorrow. So let's revisit this issue. Thank you to all of you for joining us. Thank you.